Hi, Pep. Jonathan Smith from ESPN. I just wondered what your thoughts were of the World Cup and particularly how the Manchester City players performed at the World Cup. John Stones really impressed. Just wondered your thoughts on all your players, really.
Right, been a good afternoon. I'm so satisfied, happy for them, for all of them, for the performance they did. And of course, we are not surprised because all of them, they are quality. We are surprised, like, we are so glad, like a club, being the most club, give players to the World Cup and present them there. So we are satisfied. So John, everybody, play a high level.
Brian Sandalo, Chicago Sun-Times.
What do you think visits like this mean for both the club and for supporters of the club to see Manchester City in their hometown?
Well, it's my 9th or 10th year as a manager, and every time we come here for the States, always we are, it's perfect. It's an organization being in this, an amazing country, and being in Chicago, one of the nicest city in United States, especially in that period, in winter time. I know it's tough, complicated, but I'm happy the tournament is always organized. Last season we played against top teams like United, Tottenham, Madrid, this season again. So it's a good test for, of course, the beginning of the season, and it's nice for us to prove ourselves against the teams.
Pep, Simon Stone from the BBC. You won the title last year by a record number of points, scored a record number of goals, but you've only made one signing this summer. Some of your rivals have made a lot more and spent a lot of money. Where do you think your squad is at the moment compared to where it was last season, and what are your expectations going into the new season?
Well, it was the same. We are the same player, except one person, Mr. Touré. Like, he's gone. There is the same squad. So came Riyad to help us in front, give us the quality that he has. And we're going to try to continue to improving what we started 2 seasons ago. So what happened last season, and part of that was a consequence of what happened in the first season. And we're going to try to first wait the players come back for the deserved holidays, and try to come back to the basics and see how is our intention to make a good season. And prepare the first game against Chelsea and after Arsenal and keep going. So it's a long road, so it's 11 months. It's try to be ready to play every game like we did last season. That is the point.
Paul M. Banks, thesportsbank.net. A lot of people were surprised that Joe Hart is on the roster. Where do you see him fitting in at the club?
Well, Joe is our player. So in that situation is here, and we're going to try the solution for him, for the best for him. If not, we'll stay here. He's a player. He's one of the most incredible professionals I ever met. He's training like a young guy, 18 years old. I know it's not easy for him what happened in the last period, but he's with us. Tomorrow's going to play, so he's going to be with us.
Okay, guys, can I ask you some questions that we take for Alex?
Yeah, he's here.
Show of hands. Thank you.
Alex, there's been a lot of speculation. Sorry, Stuart Brennan for the Manchester Evening News. A lot of speculation about your future. You fitted in well last season at left back, but now obviously Benjamin Mendy's back and that becomes more difficult. Have you made a decision as to whether you want to stay at City or whether you want to go?
In this moment, I play for Manchester City, and I'm so happy to be part of this team. But you never know what can happen in the future, so we will see. But I'm ready for everything.
Obviously, you say you're happy with your squad as it is, but you obviously wanted Jorginho, and it didn't happen. So there must be some disappointment there that you didn't get a player that you really went out to get.
No, but disappointed. We tried. Like you know, it already was done. But at the end, all my advice for all the players is they have to go where they want to go. And at the end, it would have been a mistake for him and for us if he would have decided to come here. We want to go with Mauricio and with Chelsea. So important is English football receive an exceptional player. But at the end, so if they want to come, it's better don't come. If they decide to go to Chelsea for the reasons he explained, or maybe he's going to explain, so all the best for him.
Luis Sanchez from Illinois, Chicago. But what do you think about the election of the Luis Enrique as a new coach for the Spanish national team, if that position is one of your dream or goals for the future?
It's an exceptional decision for the Spanish football. A part of being a friend of him is he showed his quality in the second team Barcelona, especially in the first team, when he won an amazing amount of titles in an amazing football, display of football. So I'm is a right in an incredible decision for both, for him, for the national team from Spain, and for I wish him all the best.
Pep, Henry Bushnell from Yahoo Sports. Last year, around the holiday period, you said that the fixture congestion was, I think you said it was a disaster for the players, just that they were overworked, like physically. Do you think in general that's a problem in modern football? And especially with this offseason being so short, do you feel that players are, you know, possibly in danger of being overworked?
About the short time for the holidays?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's what it is. So we start the season and the players are still playing for the last season. So, and now we have a game on 5th, the final, and 12th, we start the season, is what it is. So I lived that when I was in Barcelona, when they were in World Cup, and came back in a short time, you know, holidays. It happened in Munich as well. So you have to adapt. We're going to control, we're going to see how mentally, physically, will not be a problem, but mentally, if they are ready, they are not ready, they have to take more holidays because they have to come back ready. And we'll see. And when that situation is no stress, it's just to think how they come back and handle the situation day by day. It's what it is. I would prefer give them more time, one month and a half, because it's so many games during the season, but it's what it is. The competition is what it is, and when that's happened, it's better no complaints and adapt or adjust as best as possible.
Jesko von Eichmann, Sky Sport News from Germany. Leroy Sané didn't go to the World Cup. Was he very disappointed? Did you talk to him? What reaction do you think he will show in the next weeks, in the next month?
I think it's the past. So Jogi Löw, the Bundestrainer, decide what is the best for the national team. Leroy has said maybe this decision will make him stronger. He's so young, in 4 years, in 2 years the European Cup, in 4 years another World Cup. And he has to try to improve his game, try to keep the level they showed the last season. We are really impressed. We are so happy to have him here with us. But, you know, it's what it is. So I respect, of course, all the decisions of the managers, because Yugi has his right decisions and nothing to say. So I don't like when the other managers' opinion about my decisions. Of course, unfortunately, that's happened. And that's why I never did it in the past, never in the present, in the future, make any comments about decision of my colleagues. Always there are reasons. And Leroy, who has to accept it and move forward. So they have the challenge to, you know, to show the national team from Germany and, of course, first of all, of us. You have another chance to another season to show his quality.
Okay, that's last couple. We'll take here and then just on the front.
Just a question for Alex again. Alex, just when you must now think about what you're going to do this summer with this offer from a couple of other Premier League clubs, is it a case of do you need to go to play more football, or is it if you stay at City you win trophies?
To be honest, I am ready for everything, of course, you want to play all the time. You want to play more, and to show everyone your quality. And so we will see what can happen in the future.
Just one for Pep as well. Pep, just on that subject about players having enough rest before the new season,
On the flip side of that, is there maybe a worry that some of your players won't be ready for the start of the new Premier League campaign because you have to give them sufficient rest that they might only have, say, a week's training before the Arsenal game on the 12th of August?
It is what it is. So they know, because I spoke with them, they have to come back when they are physically, mentally ready to start like a young boy to start the season. If the days before they are tired and they are not ready mentally and like this, and they don't want to fight for the new title, the Community Shield, and start in Emirates Stadium against Arsenal, stay in holidays. When you come back, the past is the past. We cannot forget what we have done, because it will be a big mistake. But we start again, and we're going to try. If they are ready, they're going to help us. If not, we're going to wait them. We are here with 19, maybe 60, 70 players for the academy. So we have just 3 or 4 professional players in the first team. And it was a pleasure being this week, 10 days working with them to do what we have done the last 2 seasons again, start again like it was the first day, like when we arrived two seasons ago, and try to make a good performance tomorrow to do what we train in these 10 days, learn for this game, for the next one against Liverpool, the next one against the last game against Bayern Munich, and prepare the season. That is what it is. So I would prefer, okay, in our situation, all the managers, it would happen that, but it's what it is. So at the end, they won a lot of experience in the World Cup, most of the players. It will be benefit for us for the future, for that club. So that's why it's a good reason for English football as well, of course.
Hi, Pep. Just on the midfield situation, do you feel that you definitely need to sign a central midfielder? And if not, what would the solutions be? Would Fabian Delph then move in and become that central midfielder this season? No. Or
we'll decide until the last day. We'll see what happens in these games, in the other, but we have solutions, of course. Of course, we have Dinho, we have Gundogan playing that position. Alex can play in that position. Fabian Delph can play in that position. So we have a young players, 2 players here can play in that position. So we'll see. We have Douglas, we have Claudio Gomez. The young guy came from France, so we will see.
Well, that's what I was going to ask about Claudio Gomez. So he kind of officially joins the club next week. What can you tell us what your plans are for him? Is he going straight into the first team, or will he be kind of...
My opinion, in that age, they have to play. In old ages, you have to play minutes, but especially in the young. And if he cannot play with us, he's going to play in the second team, but maybe regularly, like happened last season with Phil, with Brahim. You know, stay with us and training every day with them, because what we saw in these days, the impression was so good, so good.
Pep, Mike DeCourcy from Goal.com. What do you do when you have a season that goes as well as last season went? How do you come back and make sure that the players are still as sharp and as hungry as they were a year ago?
That is my business. I did it, I handled that situation. It's not the first time. It would be my 3rd time. So that situation in Barcelona and Bayern Munich. So now here with a lot of players after European Cup or World Cup, a lot of players, 75% of the squad or 80% is in the national team, arrive late, and immediately you have a Super Cups or Cups or Community Shields or first games of the league. So that is my business, my targets. I know what I have to do.
Last question, just here, thanks.
Pep, Liz Jimenez from La Ley 107.9 FM. I would like to hear your opinion about Cristiano Ronaldo. We were really lucky to watch the best 2 of the world in Spain, but now one is gone and is in Italy. Give me your opinion about that. What do you think about that?
What should I say? So is the decision from Cristiano Ronaldo? Madrid was agreed, Juventus was agreed, so these kind of things happen. Of course, the Spanish league miss a top player. Italian league won one of the best players in the world. So nothing to say. Wish him luck and all the best.
Okay, cheers, guys.
Thank you.